Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was an explosive start to the evening. Let's move straight on to the second bout. And that is between, in the blue corner, Colas Burton, and in the red corner, Gerda Shugby.
My name is Colas Burton. I fight for FKA Association and I will fight Kurt Chelgill. I know anything about my opponent, but I will make a good fight.
My name is Gurdip Chelgill. I'm fighting at DFC and I'm fighting Colas Burton. I don't really know nothing about him. My opponent changed the last minute, so I had to change. So it doesn't really matter who it is at the end of the day.
I think I will win, but I don't know how.
My prediction is that I'm going to finish him in the second round of ground and pound.
Message for my opponent. I hope we will a good fight. We'll make a good fight. I hope I will win, but I hope it will be a nice show.
My message for my opponent is that I'm coming for his head, so be ready.
Thanks to my coach and my teammates. Thanks for the time for accorded for me. Thanks to my girlfriend, because she's here every day, and hello.
I just want to thank my sponsors. I want to thank the people that come to support me. It means a lot, and I'm going to put on a great show.
In the blue corner, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Colas Burton.
Yeah.
an amateur featherweight contest of 3 4-minute rounds. And in the blue corner, fighting out of FKA gym, weighing in at 64.1 kilograms, he stands at 1.74 meters. He's a karate fighter with a record of 1 win, 1 loss, and no draws. Kolas Bwato! And in the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, he fights at a DFC gym. He weighed in yesterday at 65.2 kilograms. He stands at 1.76 meters with a record of no wins, 1 loss, and no draws. He is Gerda Shergill!
And this fight is brought to you by Building Plastics for You. And I think this is going to be a good fight.
Not forget, guys, we are live on MATV on pay-per-view. So if you are watching, hello. And if you're not, go sign up. And here we go, fight two. Oh, that's great.
Oh, interesting there.
Here comes that karate style from the Frenchman. There we go.
Just as you predicted, Paul, he's come straight for a takedown. He's got the body lock there. And the French fighter's going for a rubber guard.
This is a pull in a rubber guard. Now, we don't see this a lot. Now, what does he need to do here, Paul? Now, if he's kind of pulling on this rubber guard, what does Shergill need to do in order to get out of this? Although it's gone now.
Well, even though it's gone now, I think the best thing he could look to do is get that shoulder pressure in. He's looking to pass the guard here. He's not looking to strike. He's grappling him. And to be more effective, he needs to put the pressure down. Even though, look, he's starting to lay a little bit more level on him. Yeah.
It's the first kind of 30 seconds where they've just sort of both gone a bit crazy. I think they're just going to, you know, give it another minute and they'll both start to calm down and ease themselves into the fight now.
Berton knows what he's doing here, though. He's recovered his guard quite well, stopping the pass. He's stuffing the head down, which can be just a big annoyance.
Yeah,
and he's doing it very well, but saying that now Shergill's looking for the head and arm there. Yeah, I mean,
this could be dangerous. If he passes that half guard...
He's trapped the arm there with his leg. He could be looking to offload some punches.
That's right, and land some strikes down. There we go. That's fantastic posture. All he needs to do, his hips are a little high. He's going to end up standing.
He's looking for an anaconda, I believe. I'm not sure if he's going to get that. Normally, you'd have to roll through to get that to create this certain angle for the leverage. The only downside to this, Paul, is now he's sat back for this submission. He's now back on the bottom.
Yeah.
With Berton now on top.
He really needs to kind of crank that face, and if the Frenchman gets out, then it changes the game completely. And now it is.
And there it is. Yeah, he's breaking through.
Oh, that was
good.
A great
scissor sweep.
Great sweep. Now he's passed. Now he's in side control.
Shergill definitely knows what he's doing on the ground here. Yes. And like you said before, with guys such as Valmir Neto and Danny Dell, he's going to know what he's doing on the floor,
yeah,
isn't he?
Absolutely, absolutely. And like, you look at the corner of Shergill, you know, all you can see is Prab Bahar and Danny Dell screaming instructions at him. And he just seems, mate, he seems to be responding. For an amateur guy, he's responding really well.
He's holding that mount well, and he's raining down punches now. And these are starting to get through, Paul. This could be the end.
Yes, I think you're right.
The ref's looking closely.
The referee's looking very closely.
Weathering the storm here.
Is that intelligently defending, Paul? What do you think?
He's done well. He got the body lock. He's got his arms up and he is defending. But how long would it be before they start to come through? See, look, he's starting to control a little bit more. It's slowing down a bit. if he just takes his time and looks to pick the right punches,
quality rather than quantity. Quality rather than quantity. You know, there we go. Now he's holding his head. There's the quality.
That's better, isn't it? Burton really needs to look to get out of this predicament. It's a bad spot.
Very bad spot.
I'm not sure how much more he can take, to be honest. He's trying to chuck his legs up here.
Punishment. The ref's looking so close. I think this is going to be stopped very soon.
He's got 10 seconds.
May well be saved by the buzzer here. There we go. There's the stoppage.
Oh, there's the stoppage.
That was a fantastic.
Wow. He was in the mount for a long period of time there. A lot of shots were going down.
Yeah, absolutely. That was a great...
Burton does look a little bit weary here. What do you think of that stoppage, Paul?
That was it was a worthwhile stoppage. You know, the Frenchman, he was struggling to get out of the position. He was stuck under the mount for a very long time, taking a lot of punishment. Now, let's not forget, Paul, these guys are still amateurs. So, you know, at the end of the day, their safety is kind of, you know, a prerogative. So, you know, with the pros, you can kind of maybe let it go a little bit more because they're kind of expecting it. With the amateur guys, you know, you want these guys to come back. You know, so you've got to look after him.
I tell you what, it was Ashurgil's slick groundwork
on both
that
sides
that made that fight, wasn't it?
It was on both sides. They had some great transitions and you know, a little bit of back and forth. It was great to see. Ashurgil kind of understood that you know, the Frenchman's strength was in his stand-up and done what he had to do to get the win.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner. At 3:56 of the first round, by TKO, from the red corner, Gerda Ashurgil! Okay, Gerda, you've brought a lot of support with you. How did that help you in your win today?
Helped me loads, man. Helped me loads. All that cheering pays off, man. Thank you very much for coming out. I want to thank my sponsor, R&R Station, all on DFC team.
Fantastic. What was the fight plan you had in mind when you came in tonight?
I come on with my fight that I drew. So I had a training camp there and I rested and done some hard training, but it worked out, man. And I took my back with a person, Jeff. Number one, Jeff.
Fantastic. Okay, so you've had a big win. You've got a big crowd. Where do you take it next?
Keep fighting, man. Keep fighting for the UFC title. That's what I want. I'm coming for that.
Ladies and gentlemen, our winner, Gerda Ashurgil!